remember the Lord's Prayer? What prayer did the Lord teach us to pray? Not my will, but thy will be done. That's the problem. Everybody's doing sex their own way. What does God think? What way did God say to do it? God said every man should have his own wife. Every wife should have her own husband. God said that it would be between a man and a woman. That's why God's calling us. That's why God's calling us. God's calling us to repentance. He's calling us today to get rid of our sin. And he's calling us today to get on board the good ship salvation. God's looking for you today, sir. He's calling you away from your alcohol addiction. He's calling you away from a drug addiction. God's calling you away from your porn addiction. He's calling you away today. Some are shopaholics, some are alcoholics, but God wants to make you a godaholic. God can change you on the inside. God can change you on the inside. Yes, there's been a lot of stuff happen in the Catholic Church. This man's talking about the abuse in the Catholic Church. Yes, that just proves what Jesus said is true. There's a lot of wolves in sheep's clothing. There's a lot of pastors and their disasters. There's a lot of priests and they have you fleeced. We're not out here to promote religion. We're out here to promote Jesus Christ. There's a difference. The Son of God lived us, loved us, and gave himself for us. The Son of God gave himself for us, and the Son of God, friends, calling you today. The Word of God's very clear, friends, today. The Word of God's very clear today. Sin is deadly. Sin takes us further than we want to go. Sin keeps us longer than we want to stay. Sin keeps us back from God.
Yeah. Can you just stay about here? Just the... There's a guy that spat on me. In there.
Oh yeah.
See what's going on in the Ukraine, what's going on with Russia. It's because there's war in our hearts. There's anger, there's rage, there's malice in our hearts towards one another. That's why there's wars in the world. That's why everybody's got tanks and bombs and planes and bullets. Because men are at war one with the other. There's a day coming, friends, when all war is going to end.
I'm surprised.
It's only going to end when Jesus comes. You see, Jesus is the Prince of Peace. Jesus is the Lord of life. He's the one that can stop the war where it starts. All war begins in the hearts of people. And where does the war come from? In our marriages, in our homes? The war comes from our hearts. Because our hearts are evil. Our hearts are sinful. Our hearts are wicked. The Bible says that we're born in sin and shapen in iniquity. That just means we're born wrong. We're born with lust in our hearts. We're born with jealousy in our hearts. We're born with anger in our hearts. We're born with bitterness in our hearts. But the Lord Jesus is the one who can take that out of our hearts. The Lord Jesus can make angry men placid men. He can make drunk men sober men. The Lord Jesus Christ can take unholy men and make them holy. That's why we're here today. We're not holier than anybody else. We were the worst sinners in our community. I used to be a drug addict, a porn addict, an alcoholic. My life was a mess. My marriage was almost broken. And I called on Jesus Christ and he saved me. You see, the problem in my life, friend, was not out there. The problem in my life was in here. I was making the wrong choices, the wrong calls, day after day, week after week. My heart was wicked and evil. And the Bible says we're all sinful. The Bible says there's not one of us righteous, no, not one.
Don't even heckle at them.
You're the only person that ever lived here.
Your problem is in there,
Jesus.
Not right here.
Yeah.
Abraham was in the Bible. He wasn't holy.
They're not worth heckling at.
David was in the Bible. Moses was in the Bible. They weren't holy. They were all sinned and fall short of the glory of God. That's why the Bible said we need
all you need to do is exist and wind them up.
That God sent was the sinner. It was his Son from heaven who never one time sinned. Think about that. Jesus lived in this world for over 33 years and he did the impossible. God sent him on Mission Impossible. And Mission Impossible wasn't for Tom Cruise to rescue. rescue somebody or save the world. Mission Impossible was for Jesus Christ of Nazareth to put on human flesh and to live in this life and never to sin one time, and to go to the cross and to die on that tree, not for his own sins, he hadn't got any, but for your sin and for my sin.